majority of people who are experimenting with cryptocurrencies are doing it through a fully custodial hosted application. So for us with Cardstack, we want people to be able to use the on-ramp of their choice. Someone who is more idealistic, have more technical skills, may want to run Cardstack Hub on their own computer and be fully in control of all the bits and bytes and information that goes in and out of the network. Someone who is new to cryptocurrency or blockchain-based application may say, hey, I want someone to host my Cardstack Hub and give me an account, and I will access it conventionally, like I'm accessing an accounting software, QuickBooks, and stuff like that. But the way we design Cardstack Hub is that regardless of how the on-ramp looks like to the end user, it's the same software, it's the same code, the same plugins that are connecting to the users to the blockchain or others cloud storage. So we encourage users to be self-sovereign and run it themselves, kind of like going to run a Bitcoin foo node or Ethereum foo node, where you are validating transaction and you're looking at everything and you have the whole history of the blockchain. And there's a lot of reason why you want to do that. On the other hand, we understand, and probably practically speaking, that most users will be using it lightly, just having an easy way to get on board. The way we have designed our system is that we haven't decided that, oh, we are centralized on-ramp, that it's like Coinbase, but for the rest of your life. But we're actually building a common set of software protocol that can then decide, have people decide later on how it's going to be deployed, whether it's as a multi-tenant share service that people can on-ramp easily by going to a website, or a fully sovereign service in a peer-to-peer way. So that's that aspect of on-ramp selection allows people to shift from easy on-ramp that gets them on the network and experience what does it mean to be using blockchain service, and move towards more and more self-sovereignty by investing either money or efforts or knowledge that's necessary to really become less dependent on hand-holding of hosting providers.